This is weird. This is, I've forgotten how to do this. My name's Danny, and I am going back to Orlando. I didn't tell anyone. Well, I told a few select friends, because I was so scared about not being able to go and testing positive for the Rona. And because of all of these pre-testing requirements that are now in place, I just didn't want to jinx it. So I didn't really tell anyone. I only told, yeah, close friends and family before going. And now it's tomorrow morning. It is currently 5:25 on Saturday, the 4th of June. I fly tomorrow morning at 9:45, so Sunday the 5th, from Birmingham to Melbourne with Tui. I know Tui are having lots of problems at the moment, so that's also stressing me out. Hopefully it all goes well. I've never flown from Birmingham before. I've never flown to Melbourne before. I know it's a new, I know it's a new flight path. I literally live 20 minutes from Birmingham Airport, so it was a no-brainer for me when I saw the prices. I'm going for 2 weeks. I'm going solo again, so I'm going to take you along for the ride. So I thought I'd just do a quick intro before starting the vlogs that I'm hopefully going to try and remember to do, and hopefully it all comes back to me and I don't just film my chin again. Yeah, I apologise in advance if I do that. I think it's going to take some getting used to again. I don't really know how these are going to go, to be honest with you. I'm there for 2 weeks. I'm using my parents' timeshare again. I know I'm very lucky to be able to do that. But I'm staying in a different resort this time. It's called Vacation Villas. No, Vacation... I've forgotten what it's called. Oh my God, that's so bad. I think it's called Village Vacation... or Vacation Village at Parkway. Vacation Village at Parkway, that's what it's called. God, that's bad. I need to remember that by tomorrow. I need to know where I'm going, don't I? Jesus. We have a timeshare at Westgate Lake Resort, so that's where we usually go. But I couldn't get in there because this was a very last minute trip. I literally booked it just under 3 weeks ago. I've just finished a university course and my exams finished on Monday, so 5 days ago now. And I had some annual leave to take, and it was kind of one of those use it, you're gonna use it or you're gonna lose it. Obviously, I started looking at Orlando, and then I found these really, really, really cheap flights from Birmingham to Melbourne. They were £200 return, mad. And then by the time I added on, I upped my luggage and I chose my seat, they were £280 return. So I couldn't say no. The only bummer is that I obviously have to then pay for a transfer on the other side, but it's still way cheaper than flying with Virgin from London for me. So, yeah, this will be fun. I'm sorry about the sun. I've had a busy, busy day of just because I didn't want to jinx anything by doing things last beforehand without knowing if I was going to be able to go because of the COVID testing requirements. So I did my fit to fly this morning with CureEdge. Really, really easy. You did the video consultation, did my test, waited 15 minutes. It was all good. took a photo, sent it off, and then I got my certificate fit to fly back about 45 minutes later. So it was about an hour in total. And then I have literally been running around like a headless chicken. I hadn't even packed properly because I didn't know, I hadn't even know if I was gonna go. I've just weighed my suitcase, it's 22.5 kilograms. So we're under. Went and got my nails done, because you can't go to Disney without getting your nails done. I've had to go to a food shop before my other half because he's away. I've just been running around like a headless chicken. I had to go get dollars because I have no dollars left. So yeah. We're here, we're going tomorrow. This time in 12 hours I should be at the airport. Hopefully, we'll see what Birmingham Airport's like. That's another stress. But yeah, I just thought I'd do a little introduction. That was a bit waffly, sorry. And I will take you along for the ride. We're going back to the magic. Ugh, I cannot, I'm so excited, I can't wait. I haven't been since November 2019. We've had, I've lost count of the amount of trips that have been canceled because of, we all know what. So yes, I will hopefully, the next time I see you should be at an airport or bright and early tomorrow morning. So yeah, let's go to Orlando. It is 6:15 in the morning and I'm checked in already.
Morning. It is at 6:25 in the morning from Birmingham Airport. I'm all checked in. It was. Can you hear the rain? That was so easy. I got here about 9:45. They didn't open check-in till 6, so we were held in the line. So I was checked in within 15 minutes. They just wanted my COVID pass, my negative test, and my passport. I printed everything just in case because I'd heard that they needed your ESTA and your proof of address and everything in America. Fine. My suitcase was a 1.5k under, which was my panic. I'm now just organising my suitcase before I go through security, which at the moment doesn't look too bad. I've got my laptop with me because I need to do some work whilst I'm out there. Just check some emails from work. That's about it. Getting all my liquids and stuff out just so I don't have to do it whilst I'm at the front of the queue and hold it up. So I will let you know how that goes.
It is 6:40 and I'm through security and I've checked in less than an hour. So now, duty free. Coming for my favourite. These look nice. I'm waiting for America for my M&Ms. Don't need snacks, do not need snacks.
I'm in Costa. Just having a cup of tea whilst I wait for the gate to be announced. I am really, really early because I got here so early. Check-in and security were brief, literally an hour tops. Then I got a cup of tea. I now have gate is advised in 1 hour and 10 minutes. So it is 7:45. My flight's in 2 hours. So long to go. But yeah, no, Birmingham Airport's been a breeze so far. I was really worried because of all the news and because of Tui, but no, it's been fine so far. It's actually dead, to be completely honest with you. So fingers crossed it all goes well. I need a bacon sandwich, and this is the biggest cup of tea with like 5 million sugars because I'm tired, man. But I'm gonna have this, get a bacon sandwich, go get a meal deal, fill up my water bottle, and then go to the gate once they let us know.
Oh, do I want sausage? I want sausage. I am back with my sausage sandwich. I cannot explain to you how quiet this airport is. It is 8:25. It is so quiet. I'm shook. I'm so confused. I thought because it's, you know, it's a Jubilee weekend. I mean, it is Sunday, I suppose, and it is the end of the week, but it's still half term for some. The gate is advised in 20 minutes. All I could think about is I could have had another hour in bed, but yeah, gonna eat my bacon sandwich, then I'm gonna go to get a meal deal because I'm fusspot and don't really like airplane food. And then we're going to wait and go see what the gate is. We finally have a gate, gate 50. So the airport's actually dead. Very, very quiet. And we're going this way to gate 50. So I obviously got here really early. Probably didn't need to get here that early, but I was panicking with all the news and the fact that it's Jubilee weekend. But here we go. Last stretch getting on the plane.
To London Orlando, please proceed immediately
to gate 50.
Is the plane's name. It's empty.
Yeah, 13.
it's half full. This is me. Lovely rainy England. So far, I have a whole row to myself. I'm not sure how long that'll last for, but we'll see. Oh, okay, let's see what we have. Apparently it's not very good. Space Jam. Oh, In the Heights. I love that film. Godzilla. Thank you. Just got a blanket. Just Murph. Okay, okay, that's it for new releases. Classics. Ooh. Which is Scooby? Creed, Wonder Woman. Oh, that's the new one, isn't it? Mad Max, never seen that. Superman, Great Gatsby, The Accountant. Oh, The Blind Side. Oh, A Star Is Born. Ooh, okay. Well, I mean, there's enough to keep you occupied, I suppose. Crazy Rich Asians. Oh, wonder whether it's the original Lord of the Rings, if they have The Hobbit. Hopefully. King Arthur, Me Before You. Oh, that's a crying film. Hang on, I'm sure I've just seen Great Gatsby again. Yes, twice. Game Night. The Dark Knight Trilogy. Aquaman. Oh, oh. Rock of Ages. Oh, yes, I'll watch that. We Are the Millers. Brilliant film. Okay, so there's enough to keep me occupied at least.
You can find a life jacket either under your seat, beneath your centre armrest, or inside your leg rest. Put it on over your head.
I live here, between the two. And I work in Stratford, but then here.
I'm also really annoyed. Not about that. I'm annoyed. I forgot to film, or press film, on takeoff. So I was holding it, pointing at takeoff, but didn't film it. Difficult. And look how miserable it is outside. Like, it's just, ugh. Only 8.5 hours ago. I really hope you can hear me. So lunch has just been served. It is 10 to 12 British time. So we took off half an hour late. So I suppose we're just over an hour and a half into the flight. They did a drink service. I'm doubling up, yep. There was no choice. It's a chicken, pasta, tomato bake. I'm not sure if I can eat this. We will see, but I've got my own backup. Just in case, this sounds nice though. Chocolate.
That's gonna focus. But chocolate and orange ganache.
Some water, some cheese, which I will not be eating. Some milk.
I'm guessing they're gonna come around with tea and coffee service and some Jacob's crackers.
Oh, and some, they must come around with tea and coffee, hence the mug. But yeah, very nice. They have said that we've already had one alcohol service. I asked, the only spirits they're doing are rum, gin and vodka. And then if we want anything else, now we have to go up to the bar. So they're not going to come back round again. I'm assuming they do one more just before we land, maybe an hour and a half before. But if we want anything, now we have to go up to the bar. Yeah. Oh, and I forgot to say, they keep handing out these cute little hand gels. Another one there, so that's two. And then cute little cutlery. And then this, oh, is my view. So I asked the very, very lovely air hostess if there were any leftover meals, because the other one was literally 99% cheese, and I mean, I know I should have pre-ordered another meal. That's just me being stupid. I don't eat cheese. It's not an allergy, it's just, I'm very, very fussy, and I'm stupid. So she, bless her, she bought me the vegetarian and vegan option instead. So this is kind of like a lentil veg bake. So hopefully this is much better. I should have taken a video of this before I started eating, but this is way better. Actually very nice. Very, very warm. Okay, thank you. Bless her. That was the nice lady who got me new food. And I got a cup of tea, a glass of rosé, and I've still got my ridiculously strong rum and coke keeping me going.
Where's the stand line?
And I'll be there.
Yeah.
At the end of August.
Afternoon tea time. The lovely air hostess managed to get me a vegan one, which is roasted veg and peach recovery, which sounds quite nice. Gluten-free. Just gluten-free and vegan. And then got a focus. It's not a focus, is it? It's basically chocolate and cherry vegan bar. Oh no, dairy, wheat, gluten-free bar. Jesus. It's something water.
Through in half an hour. Airport. Ah. Hope that squeaking is not me. That was madness. And I'm in the Floridian heat. Airport. The tent is cars, coaches, and apparently Ubers are this way. She said I can see if I can get on a coach. If there's a seat, apparently I can pay. If not, Uber. So now I'm on the TUI transfer. It was $71 return. I'm getting dropped off at the nearest TUI hotel to my hotel, and then I've got to get an Uber. But it's a fraction of the price in comparison to getting a Uber each way, but it's going to take me longer. It is 5:23, so what's that? 5:28 American English time. And I'm just leaving the airport. We landed 45, 50 minutes ago. Got the suitcase. You went through that first, bizarrely. Then you went through customs. And now I'm on the transfer to Orlando. So it'll take about 85 minutes. Because I'm not staying at TUI Hotel, I'm going to get off at the Rosen in Lake Buena Vista, and then I'm gonna get an Uber to my hotel, but it's significantly cheaper than getting an Uber.
Yeah. You can see like the whole thing under construction.
So now I'm waiting for my Uber to my resort, which is called, I hope you can see me, Vacation Village of the Parkway. My Revolut card just declined for my Uber, so I need to look into that, but hopefully he says he's here in 2 minutes. Because I need to get changed. We're finally here. That was a palaver. Melbourne, absolutely fantastic. The plane, through luggage first, which was strange, and then through customs, all within about half an hour. My suitcase was one of the last, so I think if it was one of the first, we honestly would have been through within about 15 minutes. And then I then got on the TUI coach, and the transfer paid $71 for the return. It was $41 for a single, but then an Uber was looking at, it was about $92 one way on my own, so it was a no-brainer. But then obviously it sat there for a good 15-20 minutes, and then I got dropped off at Rosen Buena Vista Suites or something like that, and then had to get an Uber from there, which was $9 to here, which took 8 minutes. So all in all, much cheaper. I'm at Vacation Villages Parkway. Gotta remember that. It's just off International Drive. I didn't realise how close it was. I can literally walk there within 10-15 minutes depending on where I want to go. Check-in was really, really quick. However, I am in the furthest blooming building possible. So if I want to actually get back to reception or where the shuttles pick you up, it looks like it's going to be at least a 10-minute walk, but they have got like the little resort hotel bus. You know what I mean? That picks you up. So I'm just going to do a really quick tour.
I'll explain how and why I've got all of this to myself later when I'm feeling a bit more alive, because my plan is to go to Magic Kingdom. I have Lightning Lanes booked and a reservation. I walked in here, I have a studio booked, and I was like, oh, this is huge, this can't be right. Double checked the number on my reservation, this is definitely it. Double checked the keys, because I've got two. They both worked first time, one of them worked the second time, one of them didn't. So I'm gonna just double check that this is definitely my room. But if it isn't, we're just gonna have a quick room tour, so let me pan you around. So, right, we're gonna start over here. Just ignore my stuff, apologies, that I've just dumped. So, this is just a studio for four people. So this is a ginormous living room, huge TV. This is a, what's it called, a pull-out. But that looks huge for a pull-out. Dining table, as I said, I'm gonna be doing a bit of work here, so I'll probably be working from there, or the kitchen. Only like 3 days in total. Kitchen, oh my god, is this a light switch? Light switch, I look rageous for that bloody switch. Kitchen, it is a studio, so it's a partial. However, I've noticed the dishwasher, so that's a bonus. Ginormous sink, I mean, it's not a hob, it's a stovetop. Ginormous microwave and an oven, it is. And a huge fridge freezer and a smoothie. I was worried that I wasn't gonna have a freezer, so this is great. Mean, really big, decent size. I'm assuming this is also equipped. I mean, it's huge for me. This is way bigger than I thought it was gonna be, to be honest with you. Big, I look really disheveled, oh God. That's gonna be a problem though. Just seen the hairdryer and I didn't pack my own, God. Ginormous sink area. I mean, it's not your usual double twin sinks that you do get in America, but I suppose this is only a studio. But I've just realized if this was for four people, there's only one sink. Oh well, it's just me. Quite a few towels. Large showers, I mean it's pretty basic, but again this is a studio so they do have like suites. Never mind, there's a jacuzzi. Hadn't been in here, ha! Jacuzzi, obviously, as you do. This doesn't look like a very big wardrobe, but oh no, it'll do. Wardrobe, ironing board, iron, safe. King size bed, TV, chest of drawers, big side bed, tables, lamps. This is what I always remember about America. There's no like lights in the ceiling, it's just lamps. Strange. Has the clock got USB ports? That's gonna be my main question as well. That's my worry. And then see if we can work out how to open this. Oh, it's already open. That's a safety hazard. And I've even got a balcony. So the next question is if the Wi-Fi reaches here. I mean, I couldn't hear the road inside, but I can hear it outside. And I'm literally on the back of the property. So this is nice, though. There's the pool behind there. If you can't see it through the trees. I mean, it's a pretty decent-sized balcony, isn't it? Hope you can see me. I'm going to quickly message my mum and Jack, let him know I've got him safe, maybe give him a call, freshen up and hopefully go to Magic Kingdom. Oh, I need to go to Publix, or that might be on the way back, and get some milk and stuff for in the morning. But yeah, update number one. Me again. So when I say I'm frazzled, that is a bit of an understatement. I'm literally the furthest blooming walk away from reception. It's right next to another hotel though, so I've just tried to get an Uber from there, but my 4G wouldn't pick up. So if I can do it from there on another time, it'd be perfect. I think I'm going the right way. I have no clue. Just kind of walking in the way the like resort shuttle bus came. That was the quickest get ready ever. It's 5:30 American time. I've just dropped my camera on the floor. Two men have already tried to pick me up. Like, do you need a lift, ma'am? But not Uber or Lyft drivers. I must look so out of place. So I'm near building 1 and 2 right now. So that must mean I'm near reception. So I'm just gonna try and get an Uber to the Contemporary and then walk over to the Magic Kingdom because that's quicker. My flip-flops are already hurting. These were my 2019 Disney shoes. And like as soon as I put them on, it dawned on me. Oh my God, I stretched them. So these might not be lasting a while, but I'll keep you updated and let you know. I'm gonna try and order an Uber now. So I think that's the road. Do you hear it? It's also hands on my hair, hence that bit. It's quite a nice temperature now because with the wind. But I think in the day it's gonna be boiling.
Just like that, I'm at the Contemporary. They wouldn't let me in. For some, I mean, I understand why. They said I don't have a, I'm not staying here. And I said, can I not just come in for a drink or get dropped off here to walk to Magic Kingdom, as was my intention. And they said, no, but you look okay, so I'll let you in. So it's now 6:05. The other driver didn't know where he was going, so he's now turning around. And my plan is to walk to Magic Kingdom, but now I'm going to have to attempt to walk past the security guard without giving me funny looks. Look at that sun. So, walkway to Magic Kingdom, Contemporary, and then we're basically just following the monorail track that I actually have to go straight past. That security guard. Hopefully he's busy with all the cars. I do this rather than getting dropped off at the transportation ticket centre. I just find it's easier, usually, if you're not stopped by the security guard. But I'll tell you how long it takes to get there. First monorail sighting. Is that Peach? And there's Space Mountain in the background.
I hope you can see me. Got my bare necessity ears on. Another pro about this is that you, little security on this side, so you don't have to do security at the Magic Kingdom. And I'll turn you around now. It's empty.
Oh, look at the little buses. So this is the buses. So these will be the buses to the Disney resorts, things like that. Also to the Disney parks after 2 o'clock. And this is the walkway we need there. That security was not even 30 seconds. I walked straight through, I held out my metal things because that's what I've read to do. So my camera, my phone, portable charger and my water bottle because it's got a metal clip on it. Didn't even beep.
Good, how are you?
Great. Let's
see if this works.
There we go.
It's over here, everyone.
I've enjoyed it.
Thank you so much. And we're going over here. Can't believe that was our first time. Oh. Meet Mickey. See, if we look at the sky over there, nice blue sky. If we look at the sky over there, grey sky. What did I do? I went and forgot my poncho. We're gonna go this way and then we're gonna look at the castle for the first time. You ready? I can kind of see it. There she is.
Yep, literally can turn around.
The parade's coming, obviously. Oh, yeah, here's a cavalcade. It's been a hectic 10, 15, 20 minutes. Can't even remember if I just filmed at the castle. Literally walked in, had some photos. Mickey's cavalcade went past, and then the adventurers one. And now I have a lightning lane for Big Thunder. But let me tell you, dark clouds, and I forgot my poncho. The one thing I forgot. Well, no, that and decent shoes. So I'm now rushing to Big Thunder. Hopefully I can get it out of the way. But I forgot how far away it is. It's not like in Paris. I forgot you've got to go all the way around Splash Mountain to get round. So I think I've got like 20 minutes left, so we're rushing. People are staring at me. I forgot about this. I've got to get used to this again. But yeah, here we go. So I managed to stack these three since landing. And now we're going on Big Thunder. Thank you. First lightning lane of the trip. So I took that screenshot at 38 and it is now, sorry about my messy screen, 56. So on and off in under 20 minutes. And I mean, I've walked a couple of minutes to where I am. So I went to go get a Dole Whip, but Aloha Isle, cute. Oh, never mind, it's ready. Quick story, went to Aloha Isle to get a Dole Whip. They'd finished mobile ordering for some reason and the queue was absolutely massive. So I'm now at Shunsign Tree Terrace, hopefully getting a strawberry one. We'll see if this works. This is my first mobile order. So I got my I Love You float with, I basically accidentally got extra strawberry. It should have had strawberry and vanilla. It's just double strawberry, but it's very delicious. And now I'm just sitting in the Hubcrest, chilling. The sun is starting to set. The Royal Friendship Fair is playing in the background. You know what I mean. I can see Goofy and Donna and Daisy and Tiana in the mall. I'm just gonna sit here, eat this and chill, and then I've got to meet Mickey. Another lightning lane. Oh, let's time this. 13 minutes past 8. This is for my sister. Guess she loves Winnie the Pooh. The east wind traded places with the west.
If you ask me, he'll never reach that tree.
If I may say, my aunt Clara went to visit her cousin,
sunnets are not working. Time check, it loads. Focus. Anyway, it's 22 minutes past 8, which means I was on and off in less than 10 minutes. It said it was a half an hour wait.
Again! Glasses are off, so I apologise for how tired I look. Like, honestly, I'm so tired, I can't remember what I haven't filmed. So, got here, had some photos in front of the castle, filmed a bit of the castle, did Big Thunder and Lightning Lane. Off and on in less than 15 minutes. The wait was 70 minutes though, normal. Then I had my lava strawberry float, true strawberry, don't do that, rookie error. Then I just sat, chilled on the hubgrass. Then I did the people mover. Then I had a lightning lane for Winnie the Pooh, and now I have a lightning lane for Meet Mickey. And then I'm gonna call it a day because I'm exhausted. Everyone's queuing for the fireworks because they're on in about an hour. So I'm hoping this will be quick, then I can just get an Uber back and go, because I'm nearly 24 hours in.
Put a Central Plaza in the dark for you. And I've just met Mickey. I'll tell you all about that later.
Me again. So I've headed out of Magic Kingdom. I'm gonna go with 8:30. No, 8:45, a bit later than I thought it was. I met Mickey, Lightning Lane, very, very quick, in and out in 10 minutes. I think the queue was only 20 minutes to wait though. However, they've replaced the photographer with that bloody box, which, till I see the photos, I don't know. I mean, the two families in front of me didn't even scan their pass. I was watching, because obviously you're all in the same room whilst you watch the family with me, and it was just flashing and flashing and flashing whilst they weren't posing, didn't get any photos of a hugs, anything like that, so. Hello, it's me again. I realised whilst editing these vlogs that I didn't end this vlog. Sorry about that. I remember I was so tired. It was verging on like 24 hours since I'd been awake. I got the Uber home and I was really like fighting not to fall asleep in the Uber. Got back to my studio and I just crashed. So obviously completely forgot to end the vlog. So sorry about that. Also, looking back at the filming in the vlog, just like I predicted, I've just filmed my lovely their chins. So very sorry about that. Realised I at times have no jawline whatsoever. Need to work on that. I've got a wedding coming up, so definitely need to work on that. So again, apologies about that. I promise you, they get better. They get better. Stick with me. I was really enjoying editing the vlogs, going through the footage and kind of looking back on it all and remembering what a good time I had in Disney. It's been a couple of weeks now. I'm obviously at home. We're in the middle of a heat wave, which is lovely. But yeah, back home now, it's been what, 2.5, nearly 3 weeks since I've been back. But the countdown is on until I'm back in Walt Disney World again at the end of August/beginning of September. We're going to New York first and then flying on down to Orlando. So yes, I'm going to end this vlog here. This is my travel day. It all went really smoothly. TUI was great. Birmingham breeze really quiet. The news made it worse than it seemed, but I think I just had I was just there on a good day. TUI, great. Melbourne Airport, really easy. The transfer was good. Magic Kingdom, very busy. I was only there for a couple of hours and then I just crashed. So yeah, that is travel day done. Tomorrow is Animal Kingdom and shopping. So yes, come back tomorrow. If you liked this video, sounds really bad me saying that, I'm really corny, but you know, any likes would be greatly appreciated. Subscribe along. There's going to be a lot more magic to come your way, more vlogs. And yes, stick along and follow along with me for some more magic.